As news of the disaster first broke, there was no place for politics. All parties equally shocked and concerned for the victims and the bereaved. Mrs. Thatcher heard the news during a meeting and at an early press conference spoke of her personal distress.
And it brings home to us very much that families have lost some of their dearest people just at a time when it's coming up to Christmas.
Later, as the rescue operation progressed, MPs began to raise questions about the cause of the tragedy and voice fears about overcrowding and safety on trains. Democrats leader Paddy Ashdown said the promised inquiry should examine whether investment in the South East Rail network should now be increased. Later, the Shadow Transport Secretary John PRESCOTT said he was unhappy for the Department of Transport to be setting up the inquiry.
We've seen a tremendous increase in accidents, deaths, and also derailments and collisions on British Rail over the last 5-6 years. I have no confidence any longer in the Department of Transport being able to do it. That's why I'm pressing very hard for an independent inquiry.
You've spoken about a crisis of confidence among passengers over safety. What do you think should be done immediately to address that?
Well, I'm pleased that the Secretary of State has set in hand the Railway Inspectorate and the Health and Safety Executive to do a preliminary inquiry, so we can look at the problems being suggested by congestion, and indeed looking at the problems of whether the signalling's right and whether there's anything immediate we can learn about the technical problems. So that's quite right and proper, but a fuller inquiry and an independent one is absolutely essential if we're to get at the real reasons that have motivated the increase, I believe, in accidents and deaths on our railway system, both above ground and below ground.